Athens College, for which I am an alumni. I'm definitely very proud of being a graduate of UTB. In fact, I'm a native of Brownsville, Texas. I come from a very law and order type of home. My father was a law enforcement officer, captain of the police force for 31 years. My mother was a hardworking individual that either managed restaurants. Sometimes both my parents had to have two jobs just to be able to provide for the seven children. And as for myself, having to be a single mom, finishing up my education was not an easy task. So it's an honor to be here, especially on campus, because I know the direct challenges that students have, particularly the students in South Texas, because I had to face many of those for many years. And the reason I've decided to run for Congress after I retired of 20 years of government service was because I saw that in Washington at this time, there's tremendous gridlock, and we're not getting anywhere. We have serious issues to deal with, dealing with just creating jobs, economic development, education, something that is being threatened every single day. There is an effort to cut down and to cut down programs, particularly Pell Grants, that are going to affect many of the children in South Texas. That simply will not happen on my watch. The third thing is also, I will fight to the very bitter end to defend our Social Security and Medicare for many of our parents and grandparents. I would also, the other issues that I see that are very important in this community are border security. And for the many reasons of that, I intend to run for Congress to give people a choice. This is democracy in action. And I thank you so much. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Ramiro Vashna. I'm delighted to be here with you this evening. I want to thank the Center for Civic Engagement and the League of Women Voters for hosting this important event. I also wish you best in Project 100% Vote, which continues success. It's a great honor to be back here in my alma mater, ETBTSC. This is where I spent a lot of time after I graduated high school in Isabel. Even though I was a working student like many of you, I was able to obtain my bachelor's degree in finance here. But I didn't stop there. I also earned my master's degree in business from this fine institution. You know, I stayed in South Texas to earn my education, and I've stayed here ever since. My background and experience that I have to offer is working with a federal empowerment zone right here in Cameron County, helping small business create jobs and attain their true economic potential. Vice President Al Gore recognized our efforts, gave us an award for producing the greatest results with the least amount of effort. I then helped the City of Port Isabel create a strategic plan, which is an economic roadmap for and prosperity for that city, and laid a foundation for the future as administrator of that development corporation. And you know, in South Texas, news travels fast, and it wasn't long before the City of Edinburgh recruited me to be their executive director of their Economic Development Corporation. In that role, I helped create 10,000 jobs for South Texas. When the rest of the country was losing jobs, I was helping create them. You know, that success led to my appointment as city manager for the City of Edinburgh, in a role where I oversaw 700 employees, I balanced a $100 million budget, and streamlined city services to make for a more effective and efficient city government. But I stepped down from that position as city manager because I want to be your next congressman, and I am fully committed to getting South Texas back to work. As your congressman, I will work hard to make sure I create an environment to create economic opportunities for good jobs, transportation, providing access to higher education, and I want to put my experience in job creation to work for you here in South Texas. Thank you.